We live in an age of fantasy, don't we, when we like to entertain ourselves with stories of dungeons and dungeons, games of gnomes and dungeons. But where did all these people... Well, Tolkien, in his book, describes how his hero lived in dungeons. It was a hobbit hole, and that means comfort. Well, believe me, there are still some people whose dream it is to live in a dungeons.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin MacLeod!
A cave. I'm being taken by lots of men in hard hats. My companion, Angelo Mastro Pietro, has bought himself a little piece of this nasty, dirty, wet hole. He's got himself a proper oozy smell, a real
big, thick chunk of wainy-edged oak,
and he's going to live in it. Wow.
Oh, my lord.
Welcome to the Rock House.
Wow.
I came mountain biking, my wife, in the near, there was some forest, some Skrenn school, torrential downpour, and one of the guys I was with, he guided us here for after 10 years, I came and there, and then change.
The 1950s. One person who knows how hard it's going to be for Angelo to find the energy to make this cave habitable is his father, retired chef and restaurateur...
Tommy!
You don't think he's taken on too much?
No, I don't think so. You got to have some sort of motivation, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Because if he hasn't got the rock to do...
Yeah.
It will be boring.
Yeah. Are you going to be involved in the construction as well?
I believe so. He will be on the phone. Dad. I enjoy spending time with him.
I don't normally pay much attention to the health and safety
20th century toilet paper.
But in this case, there's a lot of sandstone dust, which is silica, which equals
silicosis.
So best to hog up, because Angelo is a messy bugger. The red sandstone around here is from 30 years ago, when
a happy caveman
roamed the earth.
Yeah. I'll try it.
Right, your turn then, Kevin.
Okay.
Right, come on, isn't it?
Yeah.
I slap it on like paint and expect it to stick, whereas in fact it just then flakes off. You get the problem of the surface drying too quickly and the build-up's just too thick.
It's a little bit brown, but that'll dry white.
I'm surprised you, being Italian, you haven't made the kitchen the largest room in the building. Yeah? Watching Angelo work here is like watching an ancient,
suggestive virgin.
Good enough to me. It tastes like perfectly clear water, really. I appreciate it's a little bit cloudy.
Oh, yeah.
I've definitely drank worse.
Oh.
After 5 months of preparation, the cave is moving out of the Ithilili era into the Ishkedli age.
So here we go.
I feel like it should be spraying.
Smooth, milky consistency.
Everywhere, really. So 3, 2, 1.
In questi luoghi qua, dove c'è un patrimonio della collettività, molto spesso gli architetti arrivano e massacrano questi luoghi perché c'è...
Beh, beh.
Beh, no, adesso con tutto rispetto, parlo in maniera statistica.
Hai ragione.
Però ecco, statisticamente secondo me è vero, perché c'è anche un po' l'aspetto egotistico di lasciare
traccia
di se stessi, quindi attivamente su questo c'è... disgraziatamente evidente a tutti, cioè infatti purtroppo ti ho perso tanti soldi per
Hi Dad.
No day at the cave goes by without
Dad.
Let's see.
Where do we start? Do we start with the 2012?
Angelo has spent hours and hours carving out his gargantuan stone shaft.
Oh. Flush toilet, yeah, fantastic.
How thrilling. Bonkers.
This cave conversion was never just about making a cave. It has always been something of a mission.
A three? You can't lead with a three!
This is go, Johnny, go, 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 not Babalama Fizzbad.
Oh, joy. Oh, rapture. Oh, joy, oh, rapture. Dead animal on the bed.
Yeah.
Dead animal on the floor. It's all good. Jerkin. This building, I think, has the power to change, to improve his health. It is, I think, his medicine.
You expect everything just to go